Ahoy Friends!
Ahoy!
And welcome aboard the Scarlet Lady.
Yes.
It's a Virgin Voyages ship. It's their first ship. And we are on a cruise right now. Yay!
Yay!
But we thought we'd hop on and tell you guys about the cruise and basically give you a tour of the ship. So if you want to cruise on the Scarlet Lady, you kind of already know what all it has to offer and if it's going to be the right cruise for you. So what we're going to do is we're going to start from the top and work our way down, start forward, port side, wrap around to starboard, and port is left if you don't know, starboard's right, forward is front, aft is back.
Yeah.
Just like a key there for you.
Swabbing is mopping, and deck means floor.
So let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna get started on deck 16. It isn't technically the top. The top is like right here, which is Richard's rooftop, but all of this right here is for Rockstar headquarters only, which just means if you're in Rockstar suite, you get to use that area past that glass. We are not that fancy or special, so we can't go over there, but it looks like they have a hot tub and lots of lounging areas. And then right where we're standing now is just a nice little seating area next to the Sun Club Cafe, which has like poke bowls. Not right now, obviously, it's early in the morning, but throughout the day. We also have like some seatings in here, and I'll show you guys that in just a second as we start moving this way towards the aft. But right now we're in beautiful Bimini, Bahamas, which is
gorgeous.
Where they have their resort area or beach club, really.
Yeah.
The Virgin Beach Club, and we're gonna have a bonfire there tonight, so that sounds fun. But let's head this way. So as we head this way, normally all these beach chairs would be everywhere if it was like a day at sea. And then here's a look at these cool little seating areas. Reminds you of like the beach days in the 50s.
Yeah.
When you watch movies like Jaws and things like that.
You have a nice little spot to lay out, chill, read a book.
Yeah. And then over here where it says Save Water, Drink Champagne, there's usually a DJ there at night. So you can club it up over here. Excuse the wind, we are at sea. And then we have the main pool down there that's actually on deck 15 with the bar, but we'll get closer to that. But there are lots of lounging beds everywhere here. So that's really nice because we all like to lay around. So let's keep walking this way. And then we'll loop all the way around to that side. Okay, we're about midship right now. And there's some stairs to go down to where the pool is. You can also take elevators, which are in this area right here. There's some more of these seats here that look out to the sea. So we're definitely midship now. And then on this area, we also have another side to this bar over here, another bar downstairs, two whirl tubs or whirlpools, and then a big pool, which is warm but not hot, but it also has jets all the way around it.
Yeah.
So fits a lot of people and gets your massage on. There's also a lot of workout equipment just placed randomly around the ship. But I think it's mostly right in this area because if you look through those windows, that's where the gym is. It's also underneath us. And we'll get down there soon. But you also have some workout type things here. A grown-up playground, I guess. And that carries on as we keep walking aft. Word? Aftward?
Yeah.
But yeah, we got some like push-up pads here. That's what I'm going to call it anyway. And then a boxing ring.
Heavy bags.
Yeah.
You
want
to
go
it?
Punch one? Yeah.
Yeah. Hurts.
You're a lover, not a fighter.
I am not.
All right. But yeah, here's some more just free standing workout equipment. This cruise is really for the athletic types. Lots of athletic things to do.
Yeah.
On the cruise. But a lot of relaxing things to do, so.
Yeah.
So that's the end of that. We also have some more lounging bed things. We're still on deck 16. Now we're technically aft. We just came down from this way. And now we're just in like where, I call this the playground. I don't know what the technical term is, but it looks like stuff you find at a playground.
Yep.
They have the basketball courts. They actually have dodgeball games go on in here. Lots of these net loungers. A seesaw, if you want a seesaw. Seesaw at sea. And then we have some swings over here too. So this brings out the kid in you.
Yeah.
You want to swing?
Do I want to swing?
Yeah.
Sure.
Show us how we swing.
All right.
See if Chris can swing.
Oh. I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, now we're as far aft as we can be. You can see the swings right there we just got off of. There's a hot tub on each side. And then this whole back end wraps around in these big loungers. There's also a bar back here. But the coolest part, I think, about this back end piece is this net right here. So it's not open right now, apparently, but you can lounge on the net. And when you're not in port, this whole piece right here is ocean view. And then from up here, you can see this red thing wrapping around. This is on deck 17. It's really the only thing up there. And it's called the runway. So it's basically a running track that goes all the way from here to the midship where the pool is. A big loop, if you will. Okay, I just came from down there. I just wanted to pop up to deck 17 to show you the Richards rooftop area right there. But yeah, this is the runway, like I was telling you before. It goes all the way down to where the pool is, back up through here, and loops around. One loop is 250 meters. So math-wise, about 7 laps around would be a mile. But no one else is here in your way, so you can get it going pretty good. And you can't beat the view while running. All right, right back down to deck 17. I got up to the runway just by going up to these stairs, and there it is. The runway. It's a red carpet runway, by the way. So yeah, this is the lounge area in the back that we were just at with the hot tub on this side. We're on the starboard side now. Got giant chests. Just a nice big lounging area. Lots of lounging areas on this ship. I mean, it's a bunch of adults. And what do adults like to do? Lay around. They also have, in several different places around the ship, some water bottle fillers, which is really nice. Sometimes it's hard to stay hydrated when you're on vacation, and they really try to make sure that you're hydrated here. Constantly asking you if you want some water. There's water in your room, as well as those bottle fill stations. We have adult twisters, what I'm thinking this is.
Yep.
I think you can just call out whatever you want. Get people straddling things. All right, now we're walking back through to midship, and this side is filled with a bunch of these little cabanas. They do have to be reserved. I'm not 100% on how much they are, but there's 10 of them, and it just gives you some privacy. Pretty nice.
Sneaky, sneaky.
You have some charging available in here. Lounge. Yeah, nice and private. And then there's
like a VIP club.
Yeah. Hang out here all day. All day. Nice. Okay, we've walked down the whole starboard side back to forward ship. And it's basically a mirror of the port side over there. So all the way back, except that this one, instead of just a normal seating area, it ends at a seating area that you can smoke in. So this is the smoking area. It's the only place you can smoke on the ship. But they have the cigarette ashtray things for you there. So now we're gonna head in over here, use some elevators, and we're gonna go down a level and explore that level. Okay, we just came downstairs. We were on 16 and we saw all these things. Now we're on 15. There is a lot of stuff on level 15, but we're forward right now, forward. And so we're gonna show you what the rails. So from the bank of elevators, we can go out this way. We'll go to the pool deck, but I just wanted to show you that on either side is where some staterooms are up here.
Yes.
If you're on level 15.
And you can get to the galley from there as well.
Yeah. But we can also get to the galley from here. So we're gonna walk through and go see the pool. We'll go right because we're starting on the port side and we're walking backwards, so that's why the port side is on the right now. All right, so it comes right out where the pool is. So if you remember when we were up here, this is looking down the pool. I'll show you the pool real fast. So yeah, this is where the DJ is at night. Lots of shallow areas, one little deep area, another shallow area. And then yeah, lounge beds all the way around everywhere. Even in these little corners. We got another bar over here. And then right in the middle is where the towel area is. So on deck 16, when we were looking down and you could take the stairs, this is where the stairs come out at. Between the pool and like the whirlpool area. Here's a closer look. These two whirlpools are hot, but they don't have jets or anything.
Yeah.
They're just still hot water, which is really great on days where the ocean's washy.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't slosh, but everything
really nice.
Else sloshes.
Yeah.
They also have some nice plants going on here. I do like all the actual life plants on the ship. You don't see that on cruise ships a lot. And then of course we got the big jet tub in the middle. It's actually just a pool. It's not heated, but it does have all the jets in there with lots of seating for everyone, but it does slosh.
Yeah.
We learned the hard way. And there's also a bar here.
Yeah, we were flopping around in that yesterday like if we were fish. It was crazy.
And here's a little bit of a closer look of the little, the adult playground I was talking about where you could work out. We got the ladders and the monkey bars, all kinds of stuff where you could use your own body weight to
get. Want to do some pull-ups?
No, thanks.
Oh, okay.
Also, from this deck, we'll go inside and show you the inside look of the gym in just a second. But we have windows both towards the pool and out to the sea of the gym right here. And then it also goes around to this side. And so we're gonna go in right here. This is where the midship elevators are. And also where, how to get to the back of the ship. So let's keep going. All right. We're at the midship elevators. And if you ever get lost and you don't know if you're in forward, mid, or aft, you can tell by the colors. Red is mid, purple is forward, and blue is aft. There's lots of handy dandy hand sanitizer stations everywhere. Very squirty. All right, so we're staying port, so we're gonna see what's on the port side over here. Okay, so on the port side with the gym is the burn and bike side. So this is basically the cardio stuff over here. Got plenty of towels for everyone. And if you wanna use a locker, there's that. But we got some yoga stuff. This is where the bike class is. So if you're into cycling, pretty nice class. And look at that view. Woo woo. Got yoga, rowing machines, all the treadmills, ellipticals. See, and now we're on the other side of where the pool was. And then it just dead ends over here. And the other part of the gym is on the other side of the pool over there. So we'll get to that when we're on the starboard side. Okay, so still on port side, we're leaving the burn and bike complex of the gym. And we're gonna turn around, we're walking aft, still walking towards the back of the ship. And we have some men's rooms over here. And the women's on the galley is on starboard side. So yeah, now we're at the galley, which is basically on, if you've ever been on any other cruise ship, it's kind of like the buffet area, except it's more like a food court. So we have all kinds of, here's like a map of it. We have something called hot off the press, which is like paninis, noodle around, which is noodles. Let's talk about it, tacos. Popsicles, Popstar popsicles, bento baby, bento boxes. These tap thats are just beverages, like quick and go stuff. Diner and Dash, burger bar, sweet side bakery, going by, and the grounds club. And that's where we're at right now. It's at the grounds club too. So this is where you would get your specialty coffees that would cost you a little extra than if you were just getting a standard coffee. Okay, so now we're full length in the galley. This is that tap that cold where you get all your cold drinks, self-serve, and then this is the daily mix. We have like cereals and stuff. Right now it's breakfast time. And how it works is you would sit down somewhere and they will come and take your order from any of these places, yeah, and then they'll bring it to you, which is really nice. So you don't have to keep getting up and down. This is the sweet side, which is basically your sweet things like fruits, and they have desserts at night. Right now it's like oatmeals and parfaits and stuff. Keep going down the port side of the galley. So now we've come all the way down to the aft part of the port side, and we end at Gunbai. We ate here last night. It's very good. It's a Korean barbecue joint. Just give you a sneak peek of what it looks like in here. Of course, it looks way different at night when you're having dinner and stuff. But each table has the grill, and they grill your food Korean barbecue style. We'll put in a few pictures of the things that we got here, but it was, they had a menu, but our waiter was the bomb.com and just brought everything on the menu without even asking and cooked it all for us. So
yeah, it was good.
We actually ate right here, so it was wonderful. But yeah,
and he told us about, you know, how they eat in Korea. He was a Korean guy. He said, you know, we do this, this is what our family does, this is how the neighborhood acts. Like, it was like a cultural experience a little bit without being actually in Korea. Now I want to go to Korea.
Put that on the bucket list.
Yeah.
It's very windy back here, but we're all the way aft of the ship now. So this window right here would be where Gunbai ended. And then out here is all the outdoor seating for the galley. So you can sit out here and eat.
Yeah.
Up there's the net that we were on the floor above us. And then of course, you know, you have your view. So we're gonna head inside and show you the galley on the starboard side and make our way forward. Yep, so here's the aft set of elevators I was talking about. And like I said, you know what's aft because there's blue on the ground and on the label too. There's also an all-gender bathroom back here. And now we're gonna go up the starboard side of the galley. So on this side, we have the hot off the press. And here's a quick look at the whole menu for the whole galley. So like I said, you would just sit down at any place in the galley and you can order from any of the places and they'll bring it to you. But this is the breakfast menu right now. They also have a lunch menu. There's some of the hot off the press Sammy's. We got the avocado toast, it was really good. Next is the noodle around. We had the miso udon from here. And it was very good.
Yes, very, very good.
Keep walking forward. Just to show you how many seats there are. There's another drink station there. Now we're at Let's Talk About It, where they have tacos for lunch, but they have burritos for breakfast. Here's the Popstar popsicle stand. It's not open for breakfast, but normally this thing is filled with different flavored popsicles. Very good. And then in the mid part of the galley, we have the Diner Dash. This is all day breakfast, like America diner style. You got the burger bar down there, which is burgers, and then the sweet side, which is where we were earlier.
And well bred.
And well bred, yes.
like pastries and bakery stuff.
Bread. All right. Now we're going to keep it going this way. This is the bento baby. Normally they have a bunch of bento boxes here that you can just pick and go if you want, or you can order something. Okay, we've made it back to the midship elevators. So now we're on the starboard side of the same level, level 15. This is the other side of the gym, which we'll go in there in a second. We just came out of the side of the galley, and the women's room is not in this door, but around this corner, just to give you an idea, because the men's room was over there.
Yep.
So it's all confusing. And this side of the gym is called Build and Balance. So let's go in and see what's on this side. So the other side was like a black motif. This is white. You got the same lockers and towels. And this is more of the weight side of stuff. So you got a big mirror, all the mats and balls, and yeah, all of the weight building stuff that you would need. Pools over here, nice view over there. The gym.
Pick things up and put them down.
Yeah, that's how muscles are made.
Yeah.
There's also like a big classroom in here where they do like bar classes and yoga classes and stuff, with a nice view of the sea. So now we're just making our way down the starboard side of deck 15. We're just going by the pool and stuff. So all of the stuff on the forward end is gonna be just the same as the port side. And we'll go to the forward elevators so we can go down a level, and we'll start showing you level 14. Okay, we are down to level 14 now forward. And as you can see, from level 8 to 14, it's all cabins. So we'll just kind of show you the hallway, and we'll show you guys our cabin at the end. But yeah. So now we're going to fast forward, go down all the levels to level 7, where a bunch of other yummy eat places are and some bars. Take this moment to show you guys the elevator.
Going down.
Yes, we are going down. Going down to 7. But yeah, it looks like the club in here. This is probably the quietest the music's been the whole time.
Yes.
But yeah, and mirrors everywhere, so you can check yourself out, make sure you're looking good. I don't know.
7.
All right, we've done it. We've made it to deck 7 forward. On deck 7, we're gonna find all of these places. We'll start on the port side and work our way around to the starboard side. By the elevators, you will find the lineup for what's going on every day. Even though it doesn't tell you what time it is, like currently, it will tell you what time things are happening. Turning towards the port side, we have the entrance to the red room. There's also an entrance to the red room on the starboard side. We'll see that in a minute. We have some restrooms. There's an outdoor area. You could just walk around out there. There's not really much else going on over there. And right here is the groupie. This is the karaoke spot. And instead of like just big public karaoke, this is with the rooms, which I've never done karaoke like this. So you can rent a room, you reserve a room, not
yes.
Rent it. And you'll come and get one of your rooms, and then you can go inside and sing your little heart out.
It's very British.
With all your friends. So yeah, looks like they have just a few rooms. So first come, first serve. But yeah, it's fun. Here's a quick look into one of the rooms. It's really dark, but there's a screen right there. There's microphones here. It's hard to tell because it's dark. And then, you know, a place for everyone to sit while they watch you sing. And you can stand on this little thing and it'll be your stage.
Yeah.
All right. So now we are back out. And that's all, like, you can't get anywhere
right
going this way. So we're going to go outside to walk down to the mid and aft part of the ships to loop back around, so we're staying in the same theme as we are in everywhere
yes.
else. All right. Okay, we've just walked down this way on deck 7. This is where all the lifeboats are. And we are about midship right now, but I wanted to stop and talk to you about these waste baskets that you can find everywhere. So we have all the recycling or waste, which honestly, there's not a lot of waste on this ship, and it's something I really love about it. They use almost everything is reusable. There's no single use anything. All the napkins are rewashable. All the to-go containers are reusable. So yeah, really nice. So if you do have, you know, like the empty bottles or cans or anything, this is really all you see listed here would be the only waste even available to put in here. So something really nice.
It is.
Very eco-friendly as far as a cruise line can be anyway. But we also have some more lounge areas over on this side. And these are kind of hidden. So unless you know they're over here, they're probably going to be available. This is actually where we boarded the ship on deck 7 when we first got on. But they had it blocked off because these were open. And so now we're going to go inside so we can show you midship what's inside. But this would be as you board what you're headed into. Actually, I think we came in on that side, but it was on this level. So we are midship now. We came in through here. We have just like a lounge area, the draft house here. We have a place to look and listen to records. There's also a DJ here at night. If you want to plan a new cruise, and this is called the roundabout. It's the big stairwell in the middle, and there's our midship elevators over there. But this is basically like the ship's atrium.
Yes.
So if you've been on other cruise ships, this is the equivalent of the atrium.
Yes.
So when you do board the ship, you board in through those doors and they're in the atrium. It does smell like an Abercrombie & Fitch or something in here.
Yes.
Lots of fragrance being pumped in your face. So some people dig that, some people don't. So just a heads up so you know. We're gonna keep on the port side walking aft. So we're gonna pass the bank of midship elevators and stay on the port side where you can see now we're at the ice cream shop called Lick Me Till Ice Cream. Here's some of the flavors they have. They do have a vegan ice cream. It's called Green Machine. Everything else has dairy, and they have red velvet cones, salted blue corn cones, or a vanilla cone. And then we're gonna keep going through, and this is where the pizza place is. Very good pizza. They do, if you are dairy-free like I am, they do offer dairy-free pizza in here. Nice hand washing station as you get in. Of course, they're not open right now. But normally you could come in, they have like grab and go salads and stuff that you could just take. You would order your pizza here. They would prepare it for you. And you could dine in here or out there, or you can take it to your room like we did and watch a movie. So whatever floats your boat, you can do it. Okay, we've come outside the pizza place. We're gonna stay on the port side, go outside and walk down outside. There's no way to walk down anymore on the port side over here. That way we can stay on the port and wrap around, because this deck gets kind of confusing with all the back and forth and where things are, front, back, right, left. So trying to stay in one direction for you so it makes a little bit more sense on the screen. So we're gonna head out and walk back towards the aft of the boat. So we've continued to walk down from the patio of the pizza place all the way down here. There's some seating here, and we're about to walk through this glass area to the dockside patio area. There's an inside and an outside to the dockside. But this is one of my favorite areas of the ship. So yeah, we are completely aft now. Here's the dockside patio. So right inside here is a juice bar. you in there in a second. We got lots of lounging here. I love, there's a big tree, lots of plants, and a lot more of these loungers back here. So you can just sit and watch the night. That net at the top is up there. I just like the decor in this area. It's one of my favorite spots. It's very relaxing. Sit back here. There's also a bar. So we'll go in right here. We're still on port side though. So yeah, this is the juice bar. You can order fresh squeezed juices. And then this is the dock house bar that goes to the patio that we were just at.
Yep.
And it cuts through to the starboard side, the dockside bar and lounge area.
Very much a yacht club feeling here.
Yeah. I just like all the plants in this area and the blues and the whites. So yeah, we're back, completely back at the aft. So this is the back side of the dockside patio, the bank of elevators. The juice bar we just came through right here, and this is the wake. It's like a steakhouse. And now we get to head up the starboard side. Okay, so just a reminder, we're on the starboard side, walking from the aft to forward, and we just came from the dockside lounge here. We've walked down through this cool little walkway, and now we are in
social club.
The social club, and this is where you can find games. There's also a place to dine here. It's kind of like a pop shop or whatever.
Yeah.
A shake shop. Yeah, that's what I was thinking of. So here you can get like Reuben's, Philly's, vegan hot dogs, pretzels, popcorn, and that's really nice to have when you're sitting and drinking at the bar.
Yeah.
Also through here, even though we're technically going to the port side now, this is the only way to get into this piece. So we have a gaming area. So we got the foosball, the air hockeys, and there is a bar in here called the Loose Cannon. The Loose Cannon has a jukebox that you can choose whatever songs you want. This is also where they hold the trivia nights, and it gets pretty packed and lit in here. It's pretty fun. And now we're gonna walk across the little gaming room area to the actual game room where video games are. Love how the carpet matches the room in here. So yeah, here's your arcade game room. Some of these are free play. You got the Centipede. Look at Mario. Okay, we've come out of the arcade back into the game room soda shop area. We're gonna go back over to the starboard side to continue our trail to the forward of the ship. Also on this side of the gaming area, we have the shuffleboard. From the shuffleboard, we turn this way. We're headed towards that roundabout again. There's nice Instagrammable photo slash swing spots over here, as well as if you want to pay a little extra, you can actually share these to your social media account. But it's like a green screen in there, and they'll give you some fun options if that's something you're into. Now, and then we got the Grounds Club in here, which is, you know, the specialty coffee place. So we had one at the galley, and there's also one here on the 7th floor. We are on the starboard side of the roundabout. Our bank of elevators is here. The grounds was right through there. And then this is like a little library, quiet sitting area. You can also go outside right here, and there's more lounging outdoors. And then there is like a help desk. If you need help like doing your dining or using your app or anything like that, they can help you right here. And then of course, another screen telling you what's going on. And if you're ready to book your next cruise, you can do it right here. As we continue our walk forward on the starboard side, We are in a bar slash lounge called The Sip. You can also get some like breakfast items here if it's the daytime. From The Sip Lounge, we're gonna turn this way. We have made it back to the forward elevators. And here's the other side of the entrance to the Red Room. We can show you a little bit. The Red Room is two floors, so this is where the shows are at. We saw two different shows and they were both really good.
Yes.
Some are interactive and some aren't. There was a DJ here last night, so just like the dance club. So from up here, you have some seats and you can kind of see down to where the stage is. They actually add more seating for one show and then less for another. And it's really interesting how they can change this room up so much. But yeah, lots of fun going on in this room. So this is the top seating, and then you can enter through the bottom down here. We can show you that later if the doors are open.
Yeah.
Down there. So that's what we're about to do now. We're gonna go back to the forward elevators that are just right here, go down to the sixth floor where we can find more fun stuff. Okay, down to level six forward. On this level, we're gonna find all these fun things. The only thing on the port side forward, though, is something called the den. And the den is basically like where you would have your meeting spaces and offices that are in here. But then, as you can see, I can't continue to go down port side here. So we're gonna go on over to the starboard side and walk down. So we just came from upstairs of the Red Room. The bottom half of the Red Room is blocked off, so we won't be able to show you the bottom, but you kind of saw it anyways. Yep. So we're gonna turn around and we're at the casino. They have a pretty decent casino here. We got the cage, lots of slot options, and we got table games up here. So yeah, right smack dab in the middle of the casino is the Manor. It's closed right now, but it has a really fun entryway where you can walk and it looks like you're in the stars and stuff. But this is where they have like some live music and it's a bar.
Feels like
in
a
there.
Jazz club.
It does. It feels like a jazz club or a speakeasy. Like
You
kind of stumbled upon it because it is kind of like, it's not really hidden, but a lot of people are having a hard time finding it. So that's where it is, right in the middle of the casino, the Manor. Okay, from the casino, which is down there, we have walked up. We're in the High Street area. We have a bar right here. We're at the bottom of that roundabout that we were at before. Our Midship Bank of Elevators is there. We got some shopping this way, and we'll take you that way in just a second. Everything is closed right now because we are at port. But they have the Squid Ink. So this is the tattoo parlor on board. You can see in there, you can get your ink. They also have piercings available. This is the Booty Free Shop, which is basically liquor.
Yep.
We got the makeup porthole, which is, you know, they have MAC makeup in here. And you can get a little makeover if you want. We have Stubble and Groom, which is a barbershop with a nice like porthole view. So that's pretty cool. They do have the LMS products, both at the salon and at the spa. And speaking of salon, this is Dry Dock, which is the salon. As we cross the ship right here, there's the bottom of the roundabout, that same bar. They do have live music here. Elevators are right there. We're gonna go to the port side and just show you some of the shops. This is Limitado. It's like bags. They have a skin care shop here. Not really sure the name of it, but they have like makeup and skin care options in there. On this side looks like some more handbags and shoes, clothing options. And on this side we have some jewelry. But the reason why we're walking all the way back here on the port side is at the end of the shopping hall is Test Kitchen, which is a fun little restaurant where they're testing new ways to make food. So test kitchen, they use like all the food elements. So it has like a scientist lab feel in it. And I'll just give you a quick little look of what it looks like in here. So yeah, just like a lab. We ate here a couple of nights ago and it was pretty good. We'll show you a few pictures of the food that we got, but it's a 6-course meal and they just bring you one course at a time.
Yep.
And it's pretty interesting.
It is very interesting. Some of it was great, some of it not so much, but it's all worth trying.
It was an event.
It was an event, and I'm glad we did it.
Oh, yeah.
It was really kind of neat.
It was neat.
Yeah.
Okay, from the test kitchen over there, we're going to turn back around here. This is the shopping we've already passed, and we are in the aft part of the ship now. And we're going to cut across right here. And there's more shopping on the starboard side. Okay, we're on the starboard side now. That is the salon directly in front of us. This is like the Virgin shop. So it has all your Virgin merchandise. And then we have like the men's side of the skincare and clothing that was the women's side on the port side. And then we're gonna turn back around going aft. Just to show you some more of the little shops. In this shop in the little corner, this is where you would find like your toiletries and, you know, if you forgot something, you're bound to find it in here.
Yes.
And then on this side of the shopping is extra virgin. Lots of people have been raving about it. It is an Italian restaurant and it is closed right now, but here's kind of a look inside. So since everything aft on this level is a restaurant, we're gonna go to the midship elevators. We'll go down to level 5 and we'll start doing that level there. We'll give you a heads up on where we are on level 5 once we get down there. Okay, we've made it to mid level 5. As far as forward on 5, I'm pretty sure it is all rooms.
Yeah, it's crew
quarters. Crew quarters. So right here at the midship elevators is the Redemption Spa. And this is where you would come if you're getting like a facial or a massage or anything like that. We got a couple's massage a couple of days ago. It was very lovely.
Yes.
But yeah, this is where you would find it right next to the elevators. There's the spa again. We're on this side of the elevators. We're gonna turn to port side. And this is where you're going to find Razzle Dazzle. It is a veggie forward restaurant. You can find it down here. This is a great place to grab breakfast. I think this place and the galley are the only breakfast places. And this one was superior in our opinion. The men's rooms are on the port side. Women's are on the starboard side. But yeah, Razzle Dazzle's in there. It's delicious. Highly recommend it. Yeah, it was really great. Back at the elevators, we just came from Razzle Dazzle, the spa, and go to the starboard side. And on the starboard side, we have Sailor Services. There's an ATM over here if you need that. And like I said, the women's room is on the starboard side over here. And then we have the Pink Agave, which is a Mexican-inspired restaurant. It was very good.
Yes, we really enjoyed this one too.
All the restaurants have been super, super delicious. However, you do have to make reservations via your app.
Yes.
To get them, or to eat here. Or you have to eat at the galley.
Recommend doing that as early as possible, even maybe before you board.
Yeah, you can't, well, it's not open until you get on the ship.
Oh, okay.
So the earlier you get on the ship, the earlier you can start reserving your dining. Yeah, they fill up pretty fast, so.
Yeah. We've been eating at 9 o'clock most
of the time. Because we were not prepared.
Yeah.
So don't be like us. Don't be like Chris. Book your stuff ahead of time. But yeah, the Pink Agave, very delicious. The only floor left that has anything on it is level 4, which is where you leave the ship when you are at port to do the tender embarkation and stuff like that. We're not going to go down there right now because we are at port and we don't want to confuse everybody. There's also the medical center down there if you're not feeling well. And I guess there's a bar down there called the Ivy. So now we're gonna head back to our room. We are in a sea terrace room on the 12th floor, and we'll kind of show you some of the amenities of our room.
It's pretty nice.
And we'll leave you there. So let's head to the room. Okay, we have made it to our room. We are room 12086A. A just means starboard side, and Z is, I don't know, A is port side, and Z side is starboard side. So we're on the port side. Some of the stuff that you can see from here, we have a viewfinder if we want to see who's at the door. There's a doorbell for if we call for something and they're bringing it to us, they'll ring the doorbell and we'll come answer the door. This is where you put your band to open the door. The band is your room key, and that's how you charge stuff. And then this light lights up different colors. So right now it's clear because we're not requesting anything. If we push that we wanted our room clean, this would be blue. And if we put do not disturb, this would be red. So you want to go ahead and open it up?
Yes.
So it lights up green. Now we can go in. Of course, we've been living in this room for a couple of days, so it's not the cleanest. If you want to see the clean first day room tour, I'll put a link to that up in the box and in the description. But I just wanted to show you guys a brief overview of like the amenities of the room, because we didn't put that in with our other video, like some of the technology amenities. So in the room, you have your tablet.
Would you like me to demonstrate?
Demonstration. Okay, so now that it's on, they have like a bunch of movies and series you can watch, which is awesome. If you want to choose something to watch, you can do theater mode and it'll do some things. So if you just want to start a random movie,
pick the
1917
best movie of all time, and then it'll start on the TV screen here
any moment now. There we go. So it's starting to play,
and then you'll see activate cinema mode. So this is kind of cool.
You push that and then it'll shut the curtains and it gets the room ready to be movie watching.
Yeah, blue light comes on.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty cool. But it also, if you want to stop the movie, has some other cool light stuff, features.
So we'll reset the whole thing, and then we'll go to room controls. This is kind of cool.
Yeah, you can control your lights and room temperature in here. Now show us the moods.
So moods is great. This is my favorite thing.
They have a get it on mood.
They've got a get it on mood. So you hit that. Turns the TV off.
If you're ready to get it on, closes the... Ooh. Now you're ready for sexy time.
Yep. It's got a little bit of music going too. Then we've got a photo shoot.
So it'll open the curtain for you so you can get all the best natural light.
Yeah.
Take a beautiful photo.
This is find your zen.
So this is to be relaxing.
Ooh. Not a lot of...
It's just dark, which is nice.
Yeah. This is pumped up. This is ambient light and regular light.
Get the purple lights going.
Yeah. And here's hangover.
So if you have a hangover... Love how we're just opening and closing the curtains over and over again.
Hangover's like, oh, I had too much whiskey last night.
It also keeps the purple lights going.
Yep. So it's not... And then we're back to get it on.
Yeah. Super fun.
It's a lot.
All right, so there you have it. It was the full tour of the Virgin Voyages Scarlet Lady. Very beautiful ship.
Yeah.
Super simple. Plenty to eat and see, but also a lot of downtime places too.
Yeah.
So very chill, relaxing cruise if you're looking for something like that, with a lot less go, 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 and a lot more just lounging around.
That's
right. This is the cruise for you. We're ending on our balcony of the sea terrace in a hammock. All the balcony rooms have hammocks. They're super comfortable. They also sell the hammocks for $150.
I've said it at one time.
I've hijacked it because it's so, so nice. Yeah. But thank you for joining us, and we hope this tour was very helpful for you. If you have any questions for us, you can leave those down in the comments, and we'll try to answer them to the best of our abilities. And if you're looking to cruise Virgin, you'll have to hit up our friends at World of Wonder Travel. They'll get you hooked up.
Yeah, they do it upright.
Yeah. So thanks for joining us again, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.